Hello guys! Welcome to Mrs. Cipriano's Accounting Channel. Always remember, you can accounting on me! Kaya yung hindi pa nagsasubscribe dyan, subscribe na kayo! Ang i-discuss natin ngayon ay PAS 1 or Philippine Accounting Standard 1, Presentation of Financial Statements. Unahin muna natin yung objective ng PAS 1. So PAS 1 prescribes the basis for presentation of general purpose financial statements to ensure comparability both with the entity's financial statements of previous periods and with the financial statements of other entities. It sets out overall requirements for the presentation of financial statements, guidelines for their structure, and minimum requirements for their content. An entity shall apply this standard in preparing and presenting general purpose financial statements in accordance with PFRS. So dito sa PAS 1, gumamit sila ng mga terminology na suitable for profit-oriented entities. So if non-profit organizations apply PAS 1, they may need to amend the lined item and financial statement descriptions. Since ang PAS 1 ay presentation of financial statements, ano ba ang financial statements? So, financial statements are the means by which the information accumulated and processes in financial accounting is periodically communicated to the users. So, kapag sinabi nating financial statements, ay yan yung main output or end product ng financial accounting process. So, financial statements show an entity's financial position and financial performance. Kapag sinabi natin financial statements, ito din yung general purpose financial statements. So, general purpose financial statements are those intended to meet the needs of users who are not in a position to require an entity to prepare reports tailored to their particular information needs. So, in other words, general purpose financial statements are directed to all common users and not to specific users. Yung objective naman ng financial statements is to provide information about the financial position, financial performance, and cash flows of an entity that is useful to a wide range of users in making economic decisions. So, secondary objective din ng financial statements is to show the results of the management's stewardship of the resources entrusted to it. So, para ma-meet yung objective ng financial statements provide information about the assets, liabilities, equity, income and expenses including gains and losses, contributions by and distribution to owners in their capacity as owners, and cash flows. This information along with other information in the notes assists users of financial statements in predicting the entity's future cash flows and in particular their timing and certainty. Next is components of financial statements. So ito yung complete set ng financial statements. Sa reference book natin kay Conrado Valix, a complete set of financial statements comprises of number 1, statement of financial position, 2, income statement, 3, statement of comprehensive income, 4, statement of changes in equity, 5, statement of cash flows, and yung last, notes comprising a summary of significant accounting policies and other explanatory notes. So dito, ginamit niya yung income statement at nakaseparate sa statement of comprehensive income. Sa libro kasi ni Zeus, Vernon, Millan, sabi niya, a complete set of financial statements consists of 1. Statement of financial position, 2. Statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income, 3. Statement of changes in equity, 4. Statement of cash flows, and 5, notes, and yung last, additional statement of financial position required only when certain instances occur. So kay Millan, pinagsama niya yung Statement of Profit and Loss and Other Comprehensive Income. At yung pang 6, Additional Statement of Financial Position, ito kapag may mga certain instances lang yan na nire-require yung Additional Statement of Financial Position. Sabi naman kasi sa standard, an entity may use titles for the statements other than those used in this standard. So for example, an entity may use the title Statement of Comprehensive Income instead of Statement of Profit or Loss and Other Comprehensive Income. So yan yung pinagkaiba nung kay Valix and kay Millan. Baka kasi magtaka kayo, iba yung title na ginamit nila. So yung kay Valix Income Statement, nakaseparate yung Statement of Comprehensive Income, while kay Millan, so naka-combine na yung Statement of Profit or Loss and Other Comprehensive Income and nilagay niya yung number 6 na Additional Statement of Financial Position. Okay, so yan lang muna para sa video na to. Thank you for watching. Next video under pa din ng PAS 1, General Features of Financial Statements.